Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel which is Network Talks. Today we are going to see how to log the client IP address using a firewall. So normally if you are using SNET settings on your F5 virtual server, you won't be able to see the actual client IP address at server end unless the X forwarder for setting is enabled under HTTP profile on the F5. And by default, F5 does not log the client IP address who is actually sending the request. So if your requirement that you want to log the client IP address and storing it at specific location, you can achieve your requirement using a firewall. So today we will see how to write a iRule and apply it on the virtual server. So before starting our video, please like my video, share my video, and if you are new to the channel, please do not forget to subscribe my channel, which is Network Talks. So this is my F5 where I am going to demonstrate you how to log the client IP address using iRule. So for testing, I have taken one virtual server here, which is listening on 443. So if I try to access this under my browser, I am able to see the page like welcome to Network Talks. And if I see the properties of this virtual server, the SNET settings on this virtual server is enabled. So due to this setting, my backend server, which is under the pool, won't be able to see the actual client IP address who is sending the request. So where is my pool? Under resources. So under this my site pool, my backend server is available, and whoever is sending the request, that IP is not getting logged and not getting sent to this pool member. So my requirement is like I want to log that client IP address and store it at specific location. So we will do it using iRule. So to create an iRule, just go under iRules and click on the plus sign to create a new iRule. Under name, I can give any name like F5 iRule for client logging. My iRule will be like when client accepted event happens. So this is the statement. So client accepted event happens once there is a successful connection between the client and the virtual server. So in other words, post successful TCP handshake between my client and the virtual server, client accepted events happens. Under curly bracket, log local 0. So local 0 is my location. So default location for local 0 is var/log/ltm. So under this path on the F5, my client IP will get stored. Most of you are already aware, but this is just for the information. And my specific message would be client IP logged is under square bracket IP colon colon client IP, and just complete the curly bracket and finish it. So my iRule is ready. Now I will go to the virtual server, go to the properties, and under resources, I will map that iRule. So currently you will see there is no iRule map. So I am searching for my iRule which is created. So this is the iRule, F5iRule for client logging. Add it and finish it. Okay, now if you see the iRule is map here, I will go to the virtual server once, open it, and just once update that virtual server. Now I will just clear the cache of my browser, and in incognito mode I will browse it like 10.16.254. Okay, I'm getting the same page. We'll close the browser. Try one more time. 16254. So I'm accessing the page and I'm getting the right page here. So I will check at least that my iRule is getting hits. So I will go under resources, open the iRule, and go under statistics. So if you see, this is the iRule and total executions I am seeing as 3. It means my iRule is getting hits. So I will check if I am able to see the client IP address now. So to check the client IP address is logged and saved, you need to go to the CLI. First copy this iRule name because we will need this for checking it. Go to the CLI, location like var/log. Okay, now open the LTM file using cat LTM. and filter our IRUL name. Now if you see, the IP addresses logged by the IRUL which we have created is 10.29.219.51. So this IP belongs to my local system. So just to verify, I will open my CMD. We'll do IP config. My system IP address is 10.29.219.51 because I accessed that particular URL using IP address. So my IP is getting logged, and the logged IP address can be seen under LTM logs. So this way you can log the client IP addresses and store it at specific location using IRUL. Hope you find this video useful. Please like my video, share my video, and if you are new to the channel, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel, which is Network Talks. Thank you.